श्रीमती नैन्सी फर्नांडिस, डेप्टी डायरेक्टर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, डायरेक्टर ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट पंजिम। श्री आइवो रॉड्रिगेज, डेप्टी डायरेक्टर ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट साउथ मारगांव एंड मेंबर ऑफ द स्क्रीनिंग कमिटी। एंड श्री प्रहलाद देसाई, डेप्यूटी डायरेक्टर ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट नॉर्थ पनाजी एंड मेंबर ऑफ द स्क्रीनिंग कमिटी ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट एंड दे विल जॉइन अस शॉर्टली। आई वेलकम ऑल द फैमिलीज ऑफ द रोड एक्सीडेंट विक्टिम्स प्रेजेंट फॉर दिस फंक्शन। I extend also my welcome to the print and electronic media present to cover this function. Road accident deaths are very sad, very sudden, tragic and shocking when precious lives are lost. Sometimes the only bread earning member of the family has passed away, leading to emotional and financial loss and despair. The scheme titled the Goa State Interim Compensation to Road Accident Victims 2020 provides for financial assistance to the victims, families of victims against accidental death or bodily injury caused by external, violent, visible means in road accidents. The scheme was launched in the year 2010 and has been modified from time to time in order to make it easier for the families of the road accident victims to claim the compensation. The main condition of the scheme is that the road accident claim has to reach the Directorate of Transport Panjim within 180 days from the accident in order to be eligible for the compensation. The entire scheme has been uploaded on our department's website www.goatransport.gov.in. In the month of September 2020, the Honorable Minister of Transport had released compensation amounting to rupees 44 lakhs at the rate of rupees 2 lakhs each to 22 families of road accident victims, and today sanction orders to 24 families of road accident victims amounting to rupees 48 lakhs at the rate of rupees 2 lakh each will be dispersed by the Honorable Minister for Transport. The pre-receipt has to be signed and given to us in order to initiate the payment process. The Transport Department, Government of Goa, is always there to provide any assistance regarding the scheme. I would also like to inform the gathering that the National Road Safety Month 2021 on the theme Sadak Suraksha Jeevan Raksha is currently being celebrated throughout India. I would now like to invite Shri Morgan Gudino, Honorable Minister for Transport, to address the gathering.
The Deputy Director Administration, Nancy, my accounts officer, Mr. Kanekar, other officials, members of the press, print and electronic. I think, as already said, September anami, 22 loka, accident victim, claim kele tenka, poishe dile. आज 24 लोकां आमी दिता कितें दाखयता जी एक स्कीम लागू जावना नोटिफाय केल्ले आसतना आमी सिम्प्लिफाय करून लोकांक मेळटा तशें केल्लें आसा आनी हे सिम्प्लिफिकेशनाक कोण पळय विक्टीम जाता एक्सिडंटाक पर्टिक्युलरली लुजींग हीज लायफ ऑर लिम एंड पर्टिक्युलरली लुजींग हीज लायफ ताका कॉम्पन्सेशन 2 लाख आमी दिता. आज हे मुद्दम फंक्शन घडून हाडलं एकूच कारणां लागून की आनी अवेरनेस आमच्या लोकां मदें येवपाक जाय. कित्याक एक एक्सिडेंट जावप म्हणल्यार खूब कठीण परिस्थिती एक फॅमिलीचेर येता आनी तेंचे एक एकदा आधारूच आसना खंयच्या वादाक. ताका लागून इमिडियट रिलीफ तांकां 2 लाख रुपया मेळटा म्हूण आमकां जाता तितले लोकांनी हे स्किमीचो बेनिफीट घेतलो जाय. आतां तेंची इन्शुरंस आसून दी वा आनी कितें क्लेम आसून दी ते आमी तेजेर वचना. ते तेंचे तांकां कितें मेळटा ते पूण डिपार्टमेंटा कडेन सावन थ्रू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट ही सगळ्यांहून इम्पॉर्टंट स्कीम हांव समजतां. एक्सिडेंट कोणा जाल्लो नाका. एक्सिडेंट म्हळ्यार सडनली इट हॅपन्स. तुजे एक एकदां मिस्टेक आसना पूण दुसरो हाडून मारता आनी आमी पयला कितले जाण अनफॉर्चुनेट विक्टिम्स जाल्ले आसात. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल I pray for the souls of all the victims, families who have come here. I pray for those victims. Kida, unfortunately, they are not here. 2 lakh divan achi, it is not such a big amount, but at the same time, it is a big relief as well. Ebashin, amcha department da, this scheme amni kui ami simplify kelle asa. In terms of documents that are required, पहले FIR आपले बोगर accident victims are men आपले self accident बन जाले हैं self accident तो इजालो अनि complaint register के लिए police station आने सोन तो report आल्डर आप कामी दीता हम दे that simplification is there अनि ये जो आदि as जास्ता मुझे कौन male or family जाते हैं claim करता ले आणि मग असे डिस्प्यूट आहात जाल्यार तुम्ही जाणा गव्हर्नमेंट नॉर्मली किती जातात मग असे डिस्प्यूट कोणाक दिवप ना आता आम्ही ते सुद्धा सिम्प्लिफाय केले असं एक फॅमिली नसून आमच्या डिपार्टमेंटाचे लोक काळजी घेऊन व्हेरीफाय करून ही स्क्रीनिंग कमिटी जी असा ती जेन्युईन केसीस आम्ही दिवपाक केले असं म्हणून इथले 24 केसीस हे पाठी आमकां मेळलेले असा ही स्कीम चालूच उरतली ही स्कीम आम्ही कसे तुमच्या परिस्थितीत Even though we are facing pandemic, we are facing financial problem, we will not discontinue this scheme because it is the need of the hour. Every hour, if there is an unfortunate victim who meets his death, so ये आमी चालू तोर पर ये सामान ना हो समझता ये जैसे सबले victims अगर तेरे family member ये ले आसा आमी ते आमदन distribution करता ले अनि ये भाषेन कितलेचे तुम्ही पळयले असा किरे वेगळे वेगळे वस्तू जो डिपार्टमेंटचा असा आम्ही पुढे पुढे असत असा वन सच स्कीम इज इन दॅट डायरेक्शन सो आय थिंक इट इज नॉट समथिंग अनयुजुअल यू शुड फाइंड दिस डिपार्टमेंट हॅज वोकन अप लॉंग बॅक अँड यू हॅव सीन ऑल थिंग्स हॅपनिंग हे सांगून हांव समजता फुडाराकडे बरी कामां जातात ती तुमकां ऑटोमॅटीक पळोवपाक मेळटले आनी आयकपाकूय मेळटले देव बरें करूं
थँक यू सर फॉर युअर वॅल्युएबल वर्ड्स ऑफ विजडम आय विल नाऊ बी कॉलिंग आउट द फॅमिलीज ऑफ द रोड ऍक्सिडेंट विक्टिम्स वन बाय वन अँड द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्रान्सपोर्ट विल डिस्पर्स द सँक्शन ऑर्डर्स टू देम प्रेमानंद शेठ He lost his son, Pritam Sheth. Tanuja Abhijit Khandeparkar. Tanuja Abhijit Khandeparkar. She lost her husband, Abhijit Khandeparkar. Vinita Vasant Gaukar, her husband passed away, Vasant N. Nai Gaukar. Neha Naresh Naik, she lost her husband Naresh Mohan Naik. Pushpalata Borkar, She lost her son, Archal Borkar. Prashila Kavlekar. She lost her husband, Prakash Kavlekar. Shyam Sundar M. Sheth. Shamsundar M. Sheth, he lost his son Shashank S. Sheth. Arjun Prabhakar Thakur. He lost his mother Pramodini P. Thakur. Ramchandra Pandurang Gosavi. He lost his son Nikhil R. Gosavi. Marcelina Sham Fernandez. She lost her daughter Alicia Fernandez. Kashinath Gowde. काशीनाथ गावड़े
समास करते हैं सर।
अंतरुज अनिल नाइक, ही लॉस्ट हिज फादर अनिल सी नाइक। सुजैन बार्केलो जल्मी, ही लॉस्ट हिज मदर लक्ष्मी बार्केलो जल्मी। रविता दुर्गा प्रसाद शुक्ला, शी लॉस्ट हर हस्बैंड दुर्गा प्रसाद शुक्ला। एंड मंजरी परांजपे, हु लॉस्ट हर हस्बैंड अभय परांजपे। मंजरी आई थैंक ऑल आवर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट फॉर योर प्रेजेंस एट दिस फंक्शन। आई ऑल्सो थैंक ऑल द फैमिली मेंबर्स ऑफ द रोड एक्सीडेंट विक्टिम्स हु हैव कम फ्रॉम नियर एंड फार। Last but not the least, I thank the members of the print and electronic media who have covered this function. Kindly sign the pre-receipt which is there in the envelope so that we can start the process for payment. Thank you and have a wonderful and pleasant weekend ahead. Thank you.
Can I ask you something, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, as a transport minister, what is your say as far as this fuel price hike, sir? Because it will be an additional burden in this pandemic and all. So, as a transport minister, would you love to talk to CM over any discussion of what it is?
See, these are pandemic times, and you have seen the number of schemes which have been given to the people by the central government.
Mm.
And this hike is necessitated as a consequence of that. Money has to ultimately come from somewhere to fund the infrastructure schemes, to fund the schemes for the people, as well as various other expenditure of the government that takes place. It is not ideal to increase petrol or diesel prices, but when there is no alternative, money has to come from somewhere. You cannot stop spending, then also there will be criticism. This is, I say, a very temporary measure. When the economy picks up and we have the comfort level, then you will see prices coming down.
But in this pandemic time, was it okay, sir? Especially I'm saying, because of that only.
See, during pandemic times, as I said, when there is no money absolutely, and when the development of the country has to go on, when schemes have to go on, when government has to function, government salaries have to be paid, pensioners have to be paid, obviously it necessitates money. There is no alternative.
So any talks between the transport and the PWD minister as far as rastyang lagun, because आम्ही रस्त्यांचे उलयता, ॲक्सिडेंट्स उलयता, पण अजूनही ते रस्ते तशाच असत. हा म्हणणार सगळं रस्त्यांकूच लागून ॲक्सिडेंट जाता, बट द वे यू सी कंडिशन ऑफ द रोड्स अँड ऑल इन गोवा स्पेशली.
Many places in Goa, the work has started. Mm. My own constituency, where there were such big potholes, at last the work has started, and everywhere it has started. So, given a little time period, I think you will find roads better than what they are at the moment.
So, as far as this scheme is concerned, this compensation, every year 200-300 lakh victims are protected. Now, these beneficiaries are very few, 20, 24, 25. Why it is so?
No, there is a certain criteria, like there is an income limit as well. And this is for those people where really they have no support absolutely. Tenka saharachna, so tenka news patta. Unun tenka lagunus is scheme keli.
PWD department is trying to close the Zuari bridge for a certain time. May it'll this. And since it is connected towards your Vasco area plus airport, Have you spoken? Because it is a tourism and there is no alternative other than going towards Ponda.
See, one side we want the bridge to get completed as soon as possible.
Mm.
So that we can commission
four lanes.
Two lanes to go, two lanes to come. The distances will be cut short like anything. So if you are going to achieve that, then you have to ask the contractor to work faster. For the contractor to work faster, you have to close the bridge on one side.
Last is, as a GST member, how do you see this as far as budget is concerned? Then Goa getting 300 crores. You have also taken a number of time initiative as a GST member. So how do you see all this? And especially when Goa government is about to present their budget in the on March.
See, I am a GST member definitely. And the collections for January were 1,20,000 crores.
Mm.
Which shows the highest collection ever. We had touched 1,15,000 crores. Now we have touched 1,20,000 crores, which shows and is a clear indicator that things are looking up. They are brighter than what they were. So in due course of time, I expect this to be even more because compliances will be much higher. The ambit of covering the traders and all the stakeholders will be higher. With the e-way bill becoming very active, and in the GST council, I was always advocating that financial intelligence is a very big thing. With electronic footprint and entire thing is based electronically, where you file the invoices and all, we have to match the data. Finally, the finance minister in the last meeting or so, the meeting before that, complimented me and she said, finally, the demand which you have been making and you have been fighting for, use financial intelligence, match the data, do invoice matching has finally been done. Thanks that you made it a concerted effort, took it upon yourself to post the council to implement it. And I am happy to note that is also one of the reasons there are higher compliances, there are larger number of people filing their invoices electronically. And with the e-way bill coming into force in a big way, there is more income coming in. That's how it has reached 1,20,000 crores, and I expect it to be even better than that in future. Now, the other thing what you said is, yes, we have got 300 crores. As you know, Honorable Chief Minister was on record asking 100 crores, but you must realize that the center has been much kinder to us than what was our demand. When Honorable Chief Minister made demand of 100 crores, in the last Finance Minister's meeting, he sent me for the Finance Minister's meeting. I put up a very big fight. I said, Goa has been punished for performance. If you look at any indicator which shows the like highest per capita income, lowest death rate, lowest birth rate, then also other parameters, environment, tally, forest cover, all these parameters, Goa ranks number one, education ranks number three. So all these indicators are indicators of performance. That means Goa has performed very well. Then I asked the Honorable Finance Minister, are you going to punish Goa? Goans have a feeling that because we have performed so well, we are being punished. So the you have seen what is the result. She was kind enough to give us 300 crore. Now, rightly the Honorable Chief Minister said, 100 crores are going to be used for infrastructure development, are going to be used to maintain certain monuments of historical importance. It is going to be spent where necessary, where there was no money. As was the wrong impression created by people in certain quarters, as if this money is going to be used for Polga, being used for celebrations. No, this is not the time for celebrations. Government is not going to spend it for any celebration or joy making. It is seriously going to be spent to shore up the infrastructure in Goa, to keep up the social security schemes, and wherever shortcomings are there, to see that this fund is judiciously used there. This is what is going to happen to the 300 crores. No one need to worry that it is going to be spent for some shows and some entertainment and for making merry. No, a big no. This government does not believe in that.
By when we can see the implementation of new motor vehicle sector, will still take a process.
See, my heart broke when I heard the MC saying So so-and-so's husband, so-and-so's son, so-and-so's family member, they lost their life. It is so heartbreaking, I tell you. So why is the new Motor Vehicle Act being implemented, as Honorable Union Minister keeps saying, and he told me also, you think we have pleasure in increasing the fine? We want people to be more disciplined on the roads. We want people to follow the traffic rules. We want people to be conscious of their rights and accordingly not violate them as well. If this thing happens, I think your accident rate will come down to 50% straight away. Now, what was the fine? People used to say, "Kita rechamur pehdiya no sumare." So this was the thing. Now minimum fine will be 500. So there should be some deterrent. It is not the intention of the central government or the state government to penalize the people, and especially in pandemic times when they are not having income. But if you follow the rules, if you follow the traffic signal, if you don't jump the queue, why you have to pay a fine? Who will fine you? So one has to realize that you don't break the law, don't pay the fine. But the mantra has to be, you have to promote it. Don't break the law, no fine, you don't have to pay anything.
But when it would be implemented?
That implementation, your earlier question was the answer to that. Roads are bad. We are very conscious that roads are not as good as they should be. When they are good enough for people to say that that was the cause of the accident, we will implement it as possible.
So you agree roads are not in good shape?
Of course I agree.
Can we
not everywhere.
Can we expect from next financial year?
What is that?
About implementation of this?
Yeah.
See, we are trying to repair the roads as soon as possible. As soon as the roads are repaired, you will see the new Motor Vehicle Act being implemented.
What is the work?
तुम्ही आणि एक अपील करा पेरंटांक की लास्ट दोन वर्सां पयली एक 11वेचो भुरगो एक्सिडंट मेलो बुलेट एक्सिडंट ताका 10वेक बरे मार्क पडले म्हणून पेरंटान मोटरसायकल घेवन दिली आनी तो बिलो 18 इयर्स आसा अशे भुरगे मागीर एक्सिडंटान मरतात खूब जाण अशे घडले केसीस तर पेरंटूच पयली ब्रायब दिता भुरग्यांक की
बुलेट घेवन नॅचरली यंग पीपल दे रश ऑफ ब्लड तांकां समजना त्या टायमार कितें करता एक्सिडंट दाम लो गेले कंट्रोला भायर दाम करून मारले हे जावपाक जायना पेरंट्सांनी काळजी घेवपाक जाय आपले भुरग्या हॅपी दवरताना त्याचे हॅपिनस अशें जावपाक जायना की शॉर्ट टायम हॅपिनस आनी लाँग टायम डेथ अशें जावपाक जायना पेरंट्स हॅव टू टेक केअर अंडर एज चिल्ड्रन स्पेशली हू आर नॉट एलिजिबल टू ड्रायव्ह अनलेस दे गेट अ ड्रायव्हिंग लायसन्स दे शूड नॉट अलाव देम टू बी ऑन द रोड्स आय अपील टू द पेरंट्स
थँक्यू